Hey there, it's Marlene Hielema from ImageMaven.com, and in this video I'm going to be looking at the new monochrome mode that came with the May 2018 firmware update of the Lumix G9, and that is the L Monochrome D. I'm also going to be comparing that to the other monochrome modes that come standard in Lumix cameras. All right, let's go! Now, if you haven't updated your firmware yet and you have a Lumix G9 that you purchased before May 2018, make sure you check that the firmware update you're using is the latest. And in this case, I'm using firmware update 1.1. Okay, let's have a look at how you set this up in your Lumix G9. And it will be similar in all Lumix cameras. So you go to the Photo Styles menu. You can see that you have three monochrome styles to choose from. Now these are the regular photo styles, not the creative filter modes. I have a whole other video about those. And each photo style can be customized in terms of contrast, sharpness, noise reduction, color tone, and in the case of the monochrome styles, you can choose the filter effect and the grain effect. Now those filter effects are filters that we use. They're actual color filters, and what they do is they affect the black and white tones. So you can experiment with those. For example, if you put a yellow filter on, it's going to affect the yellows or the skin tones. Grain effect allows you to add simulated film grain. So those are kind of fun to play with too. You can also make a custom recipe for a certain look for your photos and video clips. Now, I do have a video on blog post with a recipe that I used for a hybrid portrait. You can find it here, and I'll put the link in the video description below. Let's look at some sample video clips of the monochrome modes. So this is the regular monochrome mode. Just check out the tonality, the highs and the lows, the black points, the white points, highlights on my face, skin tone. This is L monochrome. Again, check out highlights, shadows, darks, lights. And this is the new L monochrome D. And again, check out the highlights and the shadows, skin tone, and see what you like the best. Now keep in mind that because of the YouTube, you know, compression as well as my video compression when making my final rendering of my video, you won't see exactly what you will see yourself when you do your own testing. And as you know, I'm one of those people that says do your own testing because you're going to know what you like. Don't go by what I like, go by what you like. All right, let's look at some photos now too. Regular monochrome, L monochrome, and L monochrome D. Like I said, this video won't give you the true view, but you'll get an idea as to the main differences. Now, if you shoot RAW files, you can control the photo style in Lightroom or other photo editing app. As it happens in Lightroom, you have a similar list of photo styles that you have in your camera. How handy is that? But if the Adobe updates are lagging, then you might not get all of them. As you can see here in Lightroom, I don't have the L monochrome D, but I can see all the others. Like I mentioned before, don't confuse photo styles with the creative filter. There are some monochrome settings in there too. If you use a photo style, you have control over all the usual settings like f-stop and shutter speed, ISO, white balance, and more. Plus, you can shoot video with all the same photo styles as your photos. But with some of the creative filters, video capture isn't possible. I've got to admit, I'm kind of digging this new L monochrome D black and white mode in my Lumix G9. I've done lots of photos of my skater friends and skate parks, and I really like how it's not as flat as the regular monochrome and not as heavy as the L monochrome. So it's kind of an in-between of both of those, and I really think it's cool. It has a little more punch and doesn't have that heaviness, the heavy blacks. As of the time of this video, these Lumix cameras have the new L monochrome D photo style. Lumix G9, Lumix GX9, Lumix GH5, Lumix GH5S, and probably more. Like I said in the beginning, I'm all about testing and figuring out all this stuff for yourself. So please don't take my word for it. I want you to get out, get your Lumix camera, get on those monochrome settings, and do some comparison on different types of subjects. Maybe L Monochrome D works for landscapes, but not for portraits. So get out and make your own recipes. You know, work with the contrast, the noise reduction, the saturation, and see what happens when you mess around with the Lumix monochrome modes. All right, that's all I got for you today. Thank you for watching. If you're interested in learning more about photography or photo editing or Lumix cameras or anything in between, please subscribe to my channel. You can catch up on all my past videos by looking right here, and we'll see you next time.